Hello, a week four of Toddler Group Summer Sessions. We are having a great time. We hope you're enjoying connecting with these little videos. Today's theme is all about love. Okay, and we're going to be thinking about how God is love and how we are called to love one another. And I just wonder, who is it that you love? Is it your friends, your family? Can you name some people that you love? Maybe there's a certain type of food which you really enjoy and you say, oh, I love that food. But today we're going to particularly focus on God is love and that we are called to love other people. So again, Colin's going to share some things and then there'll be some little crafts and activities which will follow. And we hope you have a fantastic week. And don't forget, you can keep in touch and the details are at the end of the video too. Take care.
I've just been looking at a picture of one of our sponsored children. His name's Chris. And Chris doesn't live in Australia where I am now. Chris lives in the Philippines, which is a long, long way away. I wonder where you live. I wonder if there's something that God says to people everywhere. Well, I found something that is in the Bible, and it's something that God says to everyone. Somebody asked Jesus, what's the greatest commandment? And this is what he said. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. That's a lot of alls, isn't it? And the second is this. Love your neighbor as yourself. Love. It's precious. All right. I thought, I wonder what's a memory verse from the Bible that's about the greatest commandment, loving God. And I thought of Proverbs 3, 5 and 6, and it goes. Ready, here we go. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight. Whistle. Try it. If you can't whistle, go who? Who, 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 who. Proverbs 3, 5 and 6. Again, trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight. Whistle. You can do the hoo-hoo again. Hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Proverbs 3, 5 and 6. Ding! Well, that's a good verse. Trust God and acknowledge Him. Do what He says in everything you do. That's how you love the Lord. With all your heart. Now, what's a verse from the Bible about loving other people, loving your neighbor? I know. Ephesians. No, let me think. Chapter 4. Ephesians 4, verse 32. It goes. In the Bible, in Ephesians, chapter 4, verse 32. God says be kind to one another. God says be kind to one another. It's only short. You try it. Ready? In the Bible, in Ephesians, chapter 4, verse 32. God says be kind to one another. Again. God says be kind to one another. Now, sometimes people change the beginning. I don't know why. They say, when your Bible's in the freezer. Do you want to? No, we shouldn't. Okay, we're going to do it that way. All right, here we go. When your Bible's in the freezer, chapter 4, verse 32, God says be kind to one another. God says be kind to one another. One more. God says be kind to one another. Last one. God says be kind to one another. Nice. The two greatest commandments, love God and love your neighbor. Be kind to one another. And you can be kind to your family and the people very close to you. And you can be kind to your neighbor and the people that you see in your street or at the shops or people at school. And we can be kind to people who don't even live near us. Really, that's why our family were sponsoring Chris. And let me tell you about a special time, something very special that happened. I got to meet Chris. I flew from Australia all the way, a long, long way, to the Philippines. And one morning after church, I went down, the bus was outside, and someone said, "There's someone waiting to meet you on this bus." And I climbed on, and there was a seat next to Chris. And he looked at me and said, "It's finally you." And I said, "It's finally you." It was precious to meet Chris. And it's good to be kind by helping children like Chris. And it's good to be kind because God is kind. And it's good to be kind because being kind makes us feel precious and loved and treasured. Now there's a song about the love of God for us, and I think it would be a good one to sing. Jesus loves me, this I know. Jesus loves me, this I know. For the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. The Bible tells me so. Will we pray? I'm going to close my eyes. That helps me think about what I'm saying. You can pray with me. Our dear Lord and our God, we praise you because you are the great, high, perfect God. And we want to love you with all our hearts and with all our souls and with all our mind and with all our strength, just like you made us to do. And we want to love one another, love our neighbor, near and far, love our family, love those who need our help. Help us to do this, we pray, and be with us in times of trouble and times of hardship, to know that Jesus loves us with his strong, strong love. And we pray in his name. Amen.